my feet, jersey on my back, helmet on my hair, ready to attack like that.
Down in Mississippi and New Orleans, Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden league. Your team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy, and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy, and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg and I'm the only one, and when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons.
Bag up off me and watch you lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden.
Can Zeke deke again? It's a coach. You're immersed in the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up, Ezekiel Elliott, fresh off 100 yards a week ago, as it'll be the Atlanta Falcons taking on the San Francisco 49ers. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner. And standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We are about 40 miles or so south of Candlestick Point at a place that first opened back in 2014. As you get a look at Levi's Stadium here in Santa Clara, California. The scene a short time ago. This crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Atlanta Falcons. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
It's the final 3 weeks of the season. Still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. And leading them, Charles, their quarterback, their field general.
And what I enjoyed watching this week when we had a chance to watch them at practice, the easy camaraderie that he has with his offense.
A lot of respect.
A lot of respect, and frankly, I thought it spilled over to the defense. All the defensive guys were coming over and teasing and joking with him. You can tell they respect the heck out of him and really want to play well for him.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. I got you. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. Caught by Sanu. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there.
Mohamed Sanu is a guy that is often overlooked because he just quietly goes about his business. But how about last season? Had a career-high 838 yards on 66 catches, and he can also play Wildcat quarterback for you as well.
On third down, Vic. This will be caught by Brown. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
Well, that'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Here's the man who's led the league in rushing twice in three seasons, Ezekiel Elliott. The numbers for Zeke from last week, 16 carries, 111 for yards, and a touchdown.
And when he went over 1,000 yards last week, you know what it did for their offense? It gave them a true identity, because everyone's going to talk about this. The offensive line's going to take pride in it. Of course, the guy carrying the football will. But how about the coaching staff? When they go in and talk contracts, when they talk to reporters, hey, we had a 1,000-yard rusher this year. That means something in today's NFL.
Chop it.
Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Devondre Campbell flies in to blow that play up. Here's Kaepernick to throw. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Now a man who really stepped up last year. This is Matt Breida. And to the 49-yard line, but no further. And obviously, he is well short of the first. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. Here we go on fourth down with Kaepernick. And able to haul it in is Kittle. Hey, nothing to see here. Just your standard fourth down gain of 28 yards. And the drive keeps going.
Well, peel back the curtain, partner. We've got a pretty good look into how they plan to play this game. Aggressive seems to be the word. Going for it on fourth down in that situation.
Yeah, opening drive. Now, we know this coaching staff, they have traits of aggression in their history, but what a start to this game. They're going for it.
Yeah, a lot of people might say reckless, but they got it.
One. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Matt Breida. Touchdown number 22 on the season, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some
into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
He'll get 17 on that one, and the Niners have a first down. First down carry by Elliott. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Ezekiel Elliott, his 19th touchdown now on the season. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result? 6 points.
Touchdown. They had the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just 2 plays to get into the end zone. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. And he'll need to find a way to shrug off the opening drive, if you can even call it a drive. One play and an interception, so he's got to forget that.
I know that in today's football, we have a good number of coaches who don't look at time of possession the way that the old school guys did. But there's still a place for it. I think that on this drive, after having thrown that interception, they're going to eat up a little bit more clock and run some offense and give their defense a little bit of a break.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. On the draw, this will be Freeman. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
And Falcons fans everywhere excited that Devontae Freeman is back on the field wearing number 24 in the red and black. Remember, he went down in week two in 2018 with an injury and didn't return. They're hoping to see the form that led him to 1,000-yard seasons in 2015 and 2016.
Gets it off to Freeman. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. It's a pickup of 6.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 64 yards. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Now here's Vic. Malcolm Smith has now recorded 10 sacks on the season.
On any first and goal, the real estate to work with for the offense is really cut down, and the defense knows it. So they often bring heat and pressure, which they did on this play. Got him down for a loss, not a big one, but any loss of yardage in this position is tough for an offense.
They'll look to run with Freeman. And look at this, for the second straight play, the 49er defense drops him for a loss. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year, as his guys are on the board here this first quarter. Tavecchio good on the extra point, and that'll make our score 14-7. So this drive spans 7 plays, and the end result, an Atlanta touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. And you see his numbers from a week ago. He was up over 100 yards then, and he's already hit pay dirt here once in this one.
We always talk about quarterbacks and receivers getting into rhythm, right? Really feeling good, finding each other downfield. I think running backs operate the same way. They can hit a good rhythm and a good stride, and he's carrying it over from last week.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. A gain of 10 and a 49er first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete. And just one tick to go, so this will obviously be the final play of this first quarter. On second down now, it's Elliott, and he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Third down, Elliott. And a pretty nice tackle there, ranging up from his free safety spot as he'll stop him about a yard short. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up fourth down. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Remember, that was fourth and a full 2 yards. There's a big difference between that and fourth and maybe 6 inches or a yard.
Yeah, you're exactly right, because when it's that 6 inches, you just fall forward and you pick it up, right? Just go quarterback sneak. But having to move bodies, that means you actually have to execute, because they know what you're going to do. How are you going to make the right play call and get everyone into the right spot and win at the line of scrimmage? That's what they did there.
Once again, they run with Breed on first down. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
You better be afraid of me. Check 50. Check 50.
Now they'll throw with Kaepernick. And he's going to go down. It's a sack on Kaepernick. Vic Beasley making it look easy, cruising in for the sack. Kaepernick now on third and goal. And that's Elliott, complete. Call it a 3 yard gain, and that's going to make it fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Now, the offense not going anywhere. They're staying out there. They've converted once already on this drive. Here they go again on fourth down.
Go, go. Hey, Mike is 59. Mike, the 50. Ready, ready. Ready, go.
They're going for it. It's Kaepernick. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. 18 yards, first down, Niners. Kittle last year, what a season. 1,377 receiving yards, an NFL record for tight ends en route to his first Pro Bowl. Not bad for the former fifth-round pick. As you, I remember that game, December, against Denver. He had that monster first half, 210 yards. Did not have a single catch in the second half, but still those 210 yards were just 4 yards shy of Shannon Sharpe's single-game record for a tight end. And now for him on the season, that is his 80th catch, and the result is a first down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got five down to the three. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the two. The Niners on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. They're looking at a third and goal here. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. So it's been a long drive. They've held the ball for quite a while. Now what do you do here?
Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
Well, going for it on fourth has worked twice on this drive already. Now it gets more interesting here on fourth and goal. Kaepernick to throw for it on fourth. And my goodness, this is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Falcons able to muster together a goal line stand. So the magic runs out, so to speak. They were 3 for 3 on fourth down conversions, now 3 for 4.
So the defense finally gets to exhale.
Yeah.
Because they were wondering. Three.
Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than 2, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to 6. I'm a former defender. And to me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go 4. I don't know about 6.
Come on, come on. Come up to 6.
A lot of points. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And last time, they had it 4th and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Yeah, simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
Yeah, this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do.
Ready.
On play action, it's Kaepernick. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. They'll get a dozen there, and it's a 1st down, 49ers. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the 4th overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
They keep on the ground with Elliott, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. On 2nd down, here's Kaepernick. There's the Washington Husky. It's Dante Pettis.
Well, it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
On 3rd down, a run from Breida. Oh, and they had it stopped short of the first, but a penalty marker down. And that looked like a clear face mask to me. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
And now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 12 more yards there and another 1st down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
Now Elliott, and across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott with touchdown number 20 on the year, and the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Heading back onto the field, here's a look at Devontae Freeman now. They've given him some touches. They haven't had a lot of success on the ground. Do you maybe keep going to that well, or do you mix it up more?
I think you mix it up more, try and loosen things up. Get the defense to react to other people, other plays, but don't forget about it. That's your horse. You know, Secretariat lost twice in his career.
So educational. That's very true, kids. Look it up. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. To throw, Vic. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Hurry up!
The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. And finding the tight end, Hooper. A gain of 6 there on first. Clock running, and the Falcons moving with a sense of urgency. To throw again on second down, Vic. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. First and 10, here's Vic. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. To throw again. Vic swings it out to the flat for Freeman. Nifty running there, but it'll come on what should be the final play of half number one. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as they'll try to get 3 before half. So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with a 49. And just like that, on we head to half number 2. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. This one fielded at the 5. Oh, he shifts past him. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Coming up later tonight, Sunday Night Football, a good one in SoCal. The Vikings and the Chargers from Dignity Health Sports Park. Coverage at 8:20 Eastern, 5:20 Pacific on EA Sports. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Kaepernick now on first down. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Throwing now is Kaepernick. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Adrian Claiborne, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz. And even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
He's able to get four back on the run, but now they'll have to find something here on third and about 14.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
From the gun on third down, Kaepernick over the middle to Kittle, complete. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 25-yard line. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Play action. Now Kaepernick. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Out of the gun. It's Elliott. Elliott a first down and more. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown San Francisco. Ezekiel Elliott. His 21st touchdown of the season. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And he keeps carrying the ball into the end zone. And in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now. No question about it. And you talk about on his back. He's not minding the extra weight at all, is he?
On it's a fake. They'll try and throw for it. And would you believe it? This is caught in the end zone. And the fake extra point works to extend their lead by two.
Partner, they're up big. They snap the ball from the 15 for a regular PAT. Yet they fake it and get it. Is the kicker's leg tired? What's going on here?
I don't know, but defensively, now with this deficit, now you add two more onto that. They fake the PAT. That stings a little.
It definitely stings, and I know the guys that I played for, they wouldn't be as mad at the opposition as they would have been at us for allowing that to happen.
Falcons offense making their way onto the field. Let's take a look at the playoff picture coming into the weekend in the NFC. And it's right about this time of year you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go, but still plenty to be determined.
And I think for most teams, the obvious is to try and be the number one or number two seed. But when you look at it across the league and throughout the history of trying to get to the Super Bowl, the teams you really fear are the ones that get hot and sometimes sneak in at a five or a six seed because we've seen those teams actually get to the Super Bowl and occasionally win it.
Yeah, you think of the Giants a couple of times. Steelers have done it. You're right. It has happened and will happen more in the future, I'm sure. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Rush in.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. The tackle there by Richard Sherman.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Again, they'll run with Freeman. And able to get a couple as he's across the 40 to the 41.
Well, they certainly haven't been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got to just pin their ears back and get after him now.
And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And he gets it down deep into San Francisco territory. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So after the big play, look at this, all the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. Vic to throw it. They'll roll him out right. And now he's going to use his legs. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A gain of four last play. They double that here and get eight. So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half. Four down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready.
They go play action here on first down. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Throwing, Vic. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Mohamed Sanu, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Falcons get a bit closer. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to his second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And San Francisco gets set to go here. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. The pass complete to Ryan Graham. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. To throw, Kaepernick. Connects with Kittle underneath. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. And on that last catch, Charles, he tops the 150-yard mark. It's one thing when your wideout gets that. When your tight end gets it, it's quite another.
We keep seeing the evolution of that position, don't we? We've seen where it's gone from strictly as a blocker to a guy who caught a few passes to now an integral part of the passing game, sometimes the primary receiver, because a lot of these guys have wide receiver skills, and we're seeing that on display here. Just think about the guys of the past looking back at this game and saying, sure wish that was me. I'd love to have gone out for those types of passes.
To throw, Kaepernick. Open man is born. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 30.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. On first down, here's Breida. There he goes! goes left side. Touchdown, 49ers. Matt Breida with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
So that drive spanned five plays. And it was Matt Breida who had the touchdown run to put an end to it. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. Pretty move. Runs through the contact. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as he'll start at the 21-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
We're off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the 24, Vic. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
Third and short yardage, Vic. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Malcolm Smith in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Vic to throw on fourth down. Incomplete. Dan Quinn's guys unable to come through there on fourth down. And the Niners take over in terrific field position. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down 3 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them. Now you just don't get careless. Take care of the ball on the way out.
Out of the shotgun, Breida. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, touchdown number 22 on the season, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. And that rushing touchdown is 4th, puts him just 1 shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
Gould with the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. scoring summary. Three-play drive. And it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. Vic operating on first down. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. Now here's Vic. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. That first down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7.
Watch QB drop.
Vic to the air again. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. And he gets this to the other side of midfield, across the 45 before going out. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
Ito Smith, his first carry. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
To throw on 2nd and 6, Vic. And that's going to be incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Here's Vic. Gets it off to Freeman. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that'll bring up 4th down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. 4th down, and the Falcons will bring on Giorgio Tavecchio to try the field goal. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. Tavecchio puts this one through, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. Well, in the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
This is taken at the 3. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? Looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
Topper! Topper! Box track!
First and 10, here's Kaepernick. Brought in over the middle by Graham. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 15 for the Niners there, the first down.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down.
Ready, set.
Now Elliott. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one. Kaepernick to throw on second down. Over the middle, complete. That's Grant. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 35. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Kaepernick going to throw. And that's Elliott, complete. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. And now they're in the hurry up.
Check safety. A gain of a yard makes it third and 14.
Under 61. Matchbox, light, exit. Now. Ringo. Ready, go!
Kaepernick now on third and goal. And able to haul it in is Kittle. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
Mike 59.
Oh, Kaepernick's going to throw it. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy.
Oh, it's a fake. They'll try and throw for it. And he fires one incomplete. They've got this big lead. They said, forget one. We want two. Instead, they got zero.
Unbelievable they didn't even attempt it from the 15-yard line. What are they thinking? I do know this. When you fake one in this situation with that type of a lead, especially from the 15-yard line, oh, boy. I tell you what, meeting them again somewhere down the line, they'll remember this. Yeah, they'll think that they were trying to clown them a little bit.
First and 10, here's Vic. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Freeman. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 14 yards there, and a Falcon first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And this one brought in by Sanu. A gain of six there on first.
That's it, baby.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Vic now. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
Let's go.
A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Niners, they continue to make their case as a Super Bowl favorite as they move to 13-1. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, it's loss number 5 for them on the year.